話會得研究立法，喺呢個所謂黑的啊，或者的士司機喺違法嘅情況之下加重個罰則，咁啊扣分又好，停牌又好，即係除咗我哋目前咧去到法庭定罪嘅時候咧，淨係得罰錢嘅咧，我係歡迎嘅。我覺得呢個係踏出咗最緊要嘅一步，就透過呢個加強罰則咧，令到除咗罰錢咧，嗰、那個的士司機大佬本身都要諗一諗，可能影響佢未來幾個月嘅生計啊，各方面會唔會嗰方面即係小心啲咧咁。咁但係個大前提咧，就係、是、要法庭判咗佢入罪先得。咁而家喺成個的士行業同乘客之間咁多年嘅所謂糾纏咧，係舉證非常之困難。你話攬周車之又好，拒載又好，點樣樣舉證呢？就口同鼻拗。咁所以咧，每年打電話去投訴司機、的士司機咧，其實就好多好多嘅，我都唔記得咗個數字係實數係幾多啦。但係真真正正去到最後檢控咧，係一個好細嘅百分比，主要咧就根本就冇得舉證。咁所以我覺得除咗加強罰則咧，其實一定要立法規管埋咧，將來舉證係容易啲。咁我喺2016年12月嘅交通事務委員會咧，作出咗一個臨時動議咧，係獲得通過，就係、是、話要求佢哋研究立法，將來嗰啲的士或者現任咧都有個限期之內咧，所有我哋香港嘅的士咧要加裝一個閉路電視 CCTV。咁有一個叫的士推動的士發展聯會咧，係喺2016年開始咧裝咗幾廿部呢啲嘅的士。佢哋嘅做法咧就跟足我當時嘅動議，就喺個司機位後邊，佢影唔到個乘客嘅，就影住前面嘅啫，就一個錄影嘅視像。咁就車度咧就標明曬話有個咁嘅閉路電視系統，等乘客知道有件咁嘅事，跟住咧佢哋就要確保咧呢啲咧就係、是、個司機做唔到任何嘢嘅，每次影完夜晚翻去咧就交噶啦，就冇人可以睇到，除非有需要嘅時候要嚟用嘅。咁啊，當時咧私隱專員都話咗，如果你符合曬所有條件咧，係唔影響呢個所謂觸犯呢個私隱條例。咁最緊要就係而家做咗年幾啦。咁呢個推動的士發展聯會嘅結果係點呢？我今日先打去問咧，就話咧冇客人投訴過，亦都冇司機大佬咧投訴過，反而咧就大家相安無事。咁可能大家都會借鏡，就係、是、其實有好多國家當警察即係裝咗啲個人攝錄機，而家香港都準備。一段時間之後就一人一機咧，其實嗰啲投訴同埋啲衝突咧就大幅下降，因為一有咗呢啲，其實就係一個阻嚇作用多過任何嘢嘅。有咗阻嚇作用咧，大部分人都開始比較敏感啲啦，對於啲措辭啊、行為啊，或者作出一啲唔合法嘅一啲嘅要求啊性，咁所以咧，我覺得咧。其實呢一次政府如果透過立法係加強罰則，一定係要同時間雙管齊下，立法透過科技去令到舉證容易啲，因為某程度上咧，亦都保障埋司機嘅。咁係咪真係乘客投訴就大曬咧？係咪一定係乘客啱司機錯咧？如果有呢啲咁嘅系統咧？即係我聽嗰個推動的士服務聯會講咧，佢話雙方都有保障，就唔係話你講乜咧就要信曬。咁所以呢樣嘢咧，我覺得係我將會喺交委會嘅討論文件會提出。當時嘅動議咧，其實亦都係獲得我哋大多數議員係通過。我覺得係時候咧係雙管齊下去落實呢一樣嘢。如果唔係咧，做一樣就唔做第二樣咧。始終我覺得咧，就事倍就功半。 主要就係咁啦。Because basically, for all the offenses that were being filed as a complaint, the most difficult area is to provide evidence. So if you look at the number of complaints received every year versus the number of prosecution, it's totally out of whack. Simply because government prosecutors, when they look at whether they have enough evidence to bring a complaint to court, realize that most of the time they will be thrown out of court because it's all based on hearsay, because it's so difficult to collect evidence with regard to refusal, okay, or charging more than the meter. All these things actually depends on whether you happen to have deliberately have an undercover agent in a car. So most of the cases convicted in court today are through sort of undercover agents disguising as customer trying to find out what happened. Other than that, basically most of the other offenses will never be brought to trial. So I think the key problem in raising the service level of taxi today is not just increasing the strength of the penalty or the force of the penalty, but rather easier to collect evidence. And I personally believe that once you install the CCTV in the taxi, which a particular association has done about a year ago with about 40 or 50 taxi, they have received no complaint from passengers, no complaint from taxi drivers, and did not violate the privacy ordinance. All right, so that's a good test case to show that it is something that is viable. And in most other countries in the world, once you have things on camera, basically all the behavior have been totally changed in a way because it actually provide a check and balance against anyone making unlawful demands on the part of the driver. Also, from what I heard from the test case of this particular association, even the taxi driver felt that the CCTV camera in a way also protect them, not just the passengers but also the drivers, in case they have been falsely accused of certain violation of the law. So I think it is something that we need to have in this particular initiative to make the whole thing effective.